Today's lesson was to inform the students about electric circuits and that they had to be closed and how an electric circuit works, and then to show them that there are different materials that either conduct electricity or that prevent electricity from flowing that are called insulators. And that was the big idea. They needed to walk away with those three things: that there was a circuit and had to be closed, that there was a conductor that would allow, or the electricity can light up the light bulb, or there was an insulator that prevented electricity from flowing. The first part of the lesson, or any lesson, is to engage the students so that they're ready to know what's going on. So today I used a technique called turn and talk, and I gave them the essential question, which they could all identify with: what would your life be like without electricity? Okay, I heard all kinds of awesome things. Well, they need to have an identification there, and they need to be involved in it. They need to be started off knowing what we're going to do and be excited about what we're going to do and have some knowledge. Darion, what do you have to add?
I think without electricity, you wouldn't be able to use your cell phone, because without the lines outside, you wouldn't be able to send no signal to anybody who you want to talk to. You're going to have to ride all over the world to talk to somebody.
Very good. Very good. No communication. There would be no communication without electricity. The explore part, what I like to do is to just give them something to do with no instruction. They have to figure it out. And if there's a group or a couple or a team that is not being able to do it, a little whispering in the ear, a little help along the way. But generally, my expectation is to see what they can do without my instruction. And so today, they had to build a circuit. They were given a box, and they had to build a circuit. They just had the materials and had to light the light bulb. Didn't tell them how. Didn't tell them what to use. And every time I do this with different, I've done this, you know, several years, and every time I do this, they do different. Today, everybody used the switch, which is unusual, because there's a switch in there, but a lot of times they don't. So every time's different. You should have a battery holder, batteries, wires, bulb, switch, and index card. And I say that I'm gonna give you 10 minutes, but I've done this with other classes, but you know what? You guys are better than 10 minutes, I think. I'm gonna give you 5. Because I think I've got some awesome scientists in here. You want to open your container, and what your challenge is, you and your partner are going to make that light bulb light up, however you can figure out how to do it. When they're exploring, I'm looking to see that they are thinking like scientists, that they are getting that together, looking at it, saying, what do I know? It shows me that they can think. If they're not thinking, that's what the important part is, that they can think on their own. If they're not thinking, they really can't expand on that.
Let me see what you can do.
Good job, you guys are awesome. You guys all have it just right. The only thing you're missing is that this is the switch, and you have to make the connection and close the switch. Can you do that? After they have done that exploring, then I give them the objective for the lesson and what I expect them to learn from this lesson. And I do that for math, I do that for all my subjects. So today the student will be able to identify a closed circuit, the electricity needs a closed circuit, and identify a conductor and an insulator. Then they got their vocabulary words, and they needed to know the three vocabulary words: electrical circuit, conductor, and insulator. And then from that point on, I explained what those three things were, so that they now know they have got that direct inquiry knowledge, direct instruction. And so, I mean, we need that. We can't just do the fun stuff. They have to actually come away with something. What do we know about this? Can someone guess what I'm looking for? What is there between this power source, which is what?
A battery.
This is the light bulb. There is this. And I am saying at the beginning, what was the objective that I wanted you to learn? Do you remember? Mark.
Our objective was to understand that an electrical circuit must be closed so energy can flow through a light bulb.
Very good. That is exactly what we're looking for. Now, what do we know about math about something having to be closed? Robert.
Like a polygon, because a polygon, all the sides have to be closed.
Very good. You cannot have an open side for it to be a polygon, and you cannot have an opening on a circuit for the circuit to work. Well, after they've done their explore and I've explained, then we're elaborating or expanding that lesson further to where now they are doing an experiment trying to determine if a particular material is a conductor of electricity or an insulator. And they are using the circuit they prior built, and then they are trying to determine that. Before they even do that experiment, they have to make a hypothesis. They have to make a prediction. And why this is what it is, or why they think it is what it is. So before we even open that box, they have to do that. They have to be thinkers and say, this is a conductor or this is an insulator, before they even test it. So it's really important we use that hypothesis piece. The blue tube, you can put a C or an I. Do you think it will conduct the electricity? Or do you think it will not light the light bulb? I like what you're doing. Good job. Good job. You guys got it going. Good job. I will be evaluating them also in a more formal way, but what I did today is just something I like to do at the end of a lesson because I want to make sure they walked away knowing those three things. So one thing we did is we write our line of learning. So I can go around and I look to see, did they write those three things I expected? They had them in the objective. They needed to write them in their line of learning that they understood them. And then I did a little quiz where they had to say whether things were conductors or insulators, picked them up, passed them out. We graded them very quickly. And then by a show of hands, how many people had all right answers, how many people missed one, and that type of thing. So I could see, did they walk away from this lesson with knowledge? What I have learned. Absolutely. The 5 E's, I think I probably always did it before, because this lesson is not new to me this year, but the 5 E's is new to me this year with this science grant. But I did not change it. I just have identified it with the 5 E's as which part is the 5 E. But what I have definitely learned and implemented this year that I learned through the science grant is the objective. I personally had an objective for my students. I never shared that I should have. But now, whether it is reading, math, science, they have their journal that every single lesson, they write down their objective and they write the line of learning. Those two things I have learned since the science grant, objective and line of learning, and have the students share that information. That is the one big piece, and I think it makes a difference, that they know what's expected of them, and they, I think, are more engaged because they know at the end, they've got to write that line of learning, and I'm going to check it to make sure that they did come away with what they needed.